This is going to be a tutorial on how to set up and use Parsec for multiplayer. So the first thing you will need to do is come to the Parsec website and make an account. And then after you make an account, just download Parsec for your computer. And then it will open up like this. And so from here, you'll just have, you might just have this already blank. And then it will only show your computer. So just go to friends and then add friend. And you'll have to add all of the players that you want to play with by using their name or ID. And the name or ID can be found in the top right corner. And then once everybody's added, you'll have all the players connect to the same computer. So if I'm the host, you'll just have the other players connect to your computer by clicking the connect button. And then on the host computer, the names of the players who are connecting will show up in the bottom left. And you'll just click on their name and then click accept. And then from there, you'll have all the other players that are connected to you just plug in their keyboards or controllers. And usually when a person plugs in their controller into their computer, it will just make like a little ding sound on the host computer. And that's pretty much how you know that a controller or a keyboard is connected. And another important thing to know is that for Ultimate Alliance 1 and X-Men Legends, I believe, only one person can use a keyboard and mouse at a time. And I'm not really sure why this is. I think it's because the game can only read one keyboard at a time. But just keep in mind that only one person can use a keyboard, and there's no limit on how many people can use a controller. And the other important thing to know is that only one person, which is the host, only has to have the game installed, and they can also use whichever mods they want. Or they can use no mods at all and it will still work fine. So just keep in mind that if you have like three other friends that want to play and you only have the game installed, that's completely fine because only the host actually needs the game. So now I'm going to start my game and I'll show you how to enable each of the players in game. Go to options, controls options. And then from here, as you can see, I'm already set to player 1, and I'm using an Xbox One controller. And if everybody's controller is already connected, then you just go to player 2, 3, and 4, and then in device, you'll just hit select, and it will switch to whatever controller that the other players are using. So for example, usually it'll just say like, Xbox One controller 2 or Xbox controller 3, 4. It might even say controller like Xbox 360, because that's just how the game reads controllers. And as you can see here too, that only player 1 can use the keyboard, and if I try to use the keyboard on player 2, 3, 4, it won't let me use it. So like I said before, only one person can use the keyboard, and that person has to be set to player 1. So that's how you enable their controllers, and then you might also want to set their configuration from automatic to manual, and that will basically just let each player set their buttons to whichever action they want. So the host can set each control to manual, or the players themselves can just configure their controls. So that's how you do that. And then let's go in game real quick for one last step. And then go to options, or sorry, not options, go to players. And then under here, you'll be able to toggle on and off each player. And this will be based on like the number of player 2, 3, and 4 that you have already set in here. So before you can actually enable the players here, you have to make sure that their controller or keyboard is already set up here. And then once that's done, you'll be able to toggle them right here. And then once you toggle the first player, it will just say, do you want to play arcade mode or cooperative? And then just pick whichever one you want, and then they will be added into the game. If your game starts lagging, or you have the other connected players like not catching up to the host screen and it's too laggy, the best thing that the host can do is just disable the advanced lighting. If that doesn't help, then start lowering the resolution. And for me, my max resolution is 1080p, so the best resolution I would go down to is like 720p. And if that still doesn't help, then the lowest I would go is like 480p. And if none of that still helps, then you could try playing around with the network settings in Parsec and try basically just raising up the bandwidth and stuff like that. And the other thing that also contributes to like a lagless experience is trying to use wired connection, and try to avoid wireless internet if possible. And basically, just to get wired internet, all you need to do is plug Ethernet cable from your router or wherever you're getting your internet from, and plug the other end of that Ethernet cable into your PC, and that will give you a wired connection. And that should be a lot better than a wireless connection.
We'd like to thank every single one of you for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, well, why not check out some of our other content too? Feel free to leave comments down below, but please do try to keep it civil. If you want to experience any mods shown off in our videos, check out and join our community over at www.marvelmods.com or our official Discord server. Links are in the description. See you all next time.